Hi guys, in this lesson we're going to launch an application load balancer and we're going to enable access logs so that we record information about the requests that are hitting the ALB in Amazon S3. Now we're then going to use Amazon Athena to query those log files so that we can learn some information about the traffic that's hitting our application load balancer. Now there's a couple of ways you can launch your ALB. Either just do it yourself, you know how to do it, we covered it extensively earlier in the course. So create an application load balancer and you'll want an EC2 instance behind it running a web server. So you might want to use the user data from earlier in the course. Alternatively, you can skip forward to the next section, you'll find a hands-on lesson called Complex CloudFormation Template. In that particular lesson, we use a template to deploy an application load balancer. I already have my application load balancer running, so the first thing I need to do is enable access logs. In EC2, I've got my load balancer selected. Under actions, I'm going to choose edit attributes, then enable access logs, and then I'm going to give it a name for the access log location. So I've given it a name with some random characters to make sure it's unique. And what I'm going to do is select this option to create this location for me. So it will actually set up the bucket and the permissions for the bucket. So let's click on save. In S3, I can now see the bucket that's been created. And in there, there's an AWS logs folder. We can see the account number, and then there's a test file here. What I need to do now is generate some traffic. So I'm going to copy the DNS name for my load balancer. And this is the page that gets generated. Now I'm going to refresh this a few times, and what I'll actually do in the background is I'm going to switch my VPN location to a few different locations so that I get different IPs generating traffic, and that will make the results of the query a bit more interesting. I generated some traffic to my load balancer and then left it several minutes, and I've now got this folder in this folder structure within my bucket. If I click on the Elastic Load Balancing folder, we can see another one with the region, then the year, then the month, the day, and then we've got the actual zipped up archives of the logs. Now you can download these and look at them if you like. What we want to do is we want to now use Athena to query these logs. So let's head over to Athena. In Athena, we're going to click on Get Started. If you haven't used Athena before, you need to set up a query result location in Amazon S3. Now I'm simply going to use the same bucket. So mine's going to be S3:// and then I'm going to come back, take the name of the bucket, put that in, slash, and then it will be query results. And that's a folder I'm about to create. And you must have a slash on the end as well. So coming back, let's go back up to this level, create our folder called query results. So I've got that folder, and in Athena, I should have the full path here. So let me save the query results location, and now we're ready to create our database. In your course download, you'll find an Athena directory and then this .sql file. Now what we're going to need to do is copy this entire command from the create word at the top all the way down to the semicolon at the end here. But first, we need to enter our bucket name. So I have mine on my clipboard, I've entered my bucket name, then the account number, and then it should say Elastic Load Balancing slash, and then the region. In our case, it should be US East 1. So let's scroll back up and copy all of this code. In Athena, we're going to paste the code as a new query, and then we're going to run the query. And now we can see this table on the left here called ALB_logs. If you expand ALB logs, you'll see all of these categories of information that's recorded in those log files. So next we're going to query the log files. Back in the file, let's scroll down. The first one here will simply view the first 100 access log entries in chronological order. So I just need to select that code, paste it into the query editor, and run the query. And there we go. These are the results. So we can see all of the connection attempts to the load balancer. We can see the client IP addresses, the ports, the target IP, port number, and so on. So let's come back up to the top. We'll now run another query. This one is going to list the clients in descending order by the number of times that each client visited a specified URL. So again, we copy all the code, paste it into the query editor, and run the query. And so now we get the client IPs, and it's listed in the order of the number of requests they've made and the actual URL they've requested. Coming back to the file, we've got one more here. This shows the URLs visited by Chrome browser users. So we copy this code, create a new query editor window, paste it in, and run the query. And in this case, we only see one result. Now, of course, we could change this and we could try Safari, which is the browser I've actually been using. So if I now run the query, now I get more results because all of my connection attempts were made using Safari. So I'm sure you can see the power of using this tool to be able to query those log files. It makes it way, way easier being able to derive some interesting information from your ALB access logs. And that's it for this lesson. So make sure you go ahead and delete all your resources, such as your load balancer and your EC2 instances. Now, you can easily delete your table from within here as well.